Well, welcome everyone. My name is Colin, but as many of you know, my friends call me Proto Colin, and I'm the ecosystem lead for the Filecoin project, and I'm absolutely honored to participate in this week's events. The launch of a fully decentralized storage network is such an important moment in the history of Web3, and I can't wait to discuss the future of Filecoin with our community. So thank you so much for joining us this week. Today, I'm going to give a quick overview on Filecoin and outline its business case, but I'm mostly here to highlight some of the broader momentum in the ecosystem and thank some of the huge contributions from the community of miners, developers, organizations, applications, projects, and people that are actively building the network. So first, I'll touch on why the Filecoin project exists. Filecoin's mission is to create a decentralized, efficient, and robust foundation for humanity's information. We truly believe humanity's most valuable resource is information, and we're incredibly passionate about storing and protecting that valuable resource in an efficiently priced and distributed way. Now, this really means addressing some of the major problems with today's storage infrastructure, decentralizing the cloud away from a small number of centralized providers, giving users full control over their data, turning data storage pricing into an efficient market, allowing the network to set prices rather than a corporate pricing department, making storage verifiable to ensure that when someone says they're storing your files, they actually are. And lastly, optimizing the world's storage and putting these zettabytes of latent storage capacity around the world to work. Now, what this means for miners is that we move from a world where a small number of cloud storage companies control how your data is being stored and priced to a completely global open market where anyone can become a data storage provider, where the network itself can store content on every corner, bringing content right to the edge where it's needed the most by a set of clients. And of course, miners can earn Filecoin and clients can exchange Filecoin for this valuable service. Now, before we dive into the ecosystem overview, I'll do a quick segment on the business case for Filecoin, and I'll start with the overall demand for data storage. The amount of data we generate as a species is growing at an absolutely alarming rate. In 2020, the total amount of data generated around the world was 58 zettabytes, and that's expected to grow by 3x in the next 4 years to over 175 zettabytes. Now, what's even more important is that today, only 7% of the world's data that gets generated actually gets stored, and that ratio is decreasing over time. It'll be down to 5% in the next 4 years. Today's cloud storage infrastructure simply cannot keep up with the demand, and we need to explore a different model if we want to set the web up for success in the future. So Filecoin also transforms the fundamental business case and cost structure to be a storage provider in today's economy. Now, in 2020, to be a great storage provider, you need lots of things: disks, tape, server administration, great connectivity, but also things like good customer support, good marketing, good sales, you have to form a company, et cetera. Now, Filecoin allows storage providers to focus on the core business backend, a subset of the most valuable tasks that a storage provider can do, and offloads the business frontend to the Filecoin network itself. So similar to the powerful service Airbnb's network provides for individual homeowners to allow them to compete with larger hotels like Marriott and Hilton, Filecoin takes a market with some dominant cloud storage providers today and allows all sorts of data storage providers to be able to compete effectively with the scale, reliability, and price efficiency of the larger players. This really allows anyone from a small mining rig to an advanced data center to plug into the network and together provide a new robust foundation for humanity's information. Now, onto the ecosystem overview, which is really my favorite part and what I love to talk about with our community. I'll start by saying it's really important to note that Filecoin is not just software. Filecoin is really a rapidly growing ecosystem of thousands of talented people working towards a common goal. The momentum is like a high-speed train that cannot be stopped. Every day, more talented developers, entrepreneurs, partners, community members join the ecosystem, and it's the strength and growth of that ecosystem that makes Filecoin incredibly unique. It's also why my job as the ecosystem lead here is incredibly easy. Now, I'm going to spend the bulk of my presentation thanking four different sets of stakeholders in the Filecoin ecosystem: miners, applications and clients, community members, and new projects. And I'll start with miners. The Filecoin mining community is absolutely thriving. Today, we have over 550 miners on the network, and this ranges from individual folks mining in their homes to really large data centers around the world. Now, together, that community of miners has grown the power in the network from 0 to 600 petabytes in just under 2 months. And that is an incredible achievement. That's the equivalent of 1.5 million MacBook Pros, or enough to store 170 high-definition movies, 2,500 Wikipedias, or 100 Netflix movie archives. A lot of these facilities are actually incredibly professional, and you can check out many of the videos online too that speak to some of the quality of some of the larger operations. In addition, the network power is actually quite distributed, even more so than some of the large existing crypto networks. No miner today has more than 7% of the network's power, which really makes it a completely decentralized network. And geographically, we're distributed all over the world. Initially, there was the mining presence in Asia was dominant, but North America and Europe and other continents are making big gains recently, and you can see that on the map today. So it's really enough to say that the Filecoin mining community sets the tone for the network. And so I want to issue just a huge, incredible thank you to the mining partners that are investing for the long-term health of the network and its community. You guys are really the heart and soul of Filecoin, and we thank you for taking a long-term view. So next, I'll cover some of the applications and clients that are joining the Filecoin ecosystem. Now, there are over 90 significant and professional organizations engaging in the Filecoin network today, and you can see a huge list of them on this map. And it's also worth noting that we are just tremendous benefactors of the IPFS ecosystem that's been growing for the last 5 or 6 years. The IPFS ecosystem has a tremendous amount of use cases and has been growing roughly at 10 times every year. The community of IPFS applications will always be a critical user of Filecoin, particularly for persistent storage. And so we're making it very easy for them to integrate. So stemming from that, the landscape of applications and clients that are exploding are absolutely exploding within the Filecoin ecosystem. And I'm just going to highlight just a few of them today. So first off, Slate. Slate is, in my opinion, one of the best consumer applications in Web3. It's a total best-in-class experience for uploading, collecting, and sharing media, and it's completely open source, the first step towards enabling a thriving network for data storage and transactions powered by IPFS, Filecoin, and Textile that is open and usable by everyone. If you haven't tried Slate, please get on board. It's an absolutely incredible product. Next, Fleek's Space application is a completely open source private file storage and sharing and collaboration platform that's also built on Filecoin, IPFS, and PowerGate. So you can think of Space as a private, encrypted, peer-to-peer version of Dropbox or Google Drive, and it's absolutely beautifully designed. Now onto the world of DeFi use cases. There's a whole host of DeFi applications popping up on Filecoin, including two that I'll highlight today. Codify recently launched their Filecoin storage market. And so this is a miner marketplace where miners can announce pricing and availability to the marketplace and be browsed by clients. And second, a collateralized loan marketplace that allows token holders to lend Filecoin to stakeholders using Ethereum smart contracts. And in order to do that, they tokenized Filecoin using Renfill on Ethereum, which is an absolutely incredible achievement. I think it is set to launch in November. Filecoin is also collaborating with LivePeer to bring the future of decentralized video to the world. I'll highlight just two applications that are taking advantage of that combined stack. Vudify and Build Labs and others are building decentralized video applications that are incredibly easy to use. And built on top of LivePeer and Filecoin is a complete technology stack, which is remarkable. OpenBazaar and Haven have actually integrated Filecoin as a payments mechanism for their decentralized marketplace. And we expect there to be many other payments use cases popping up soon. Starling is an application that adds verified storage to Filecoin and guarantees that the archival data that folks view on Filecoin haven't been tampered with, which opens up a huge number of use cases for verifiable storage, some of which that we'll announce for the first time later this week, which is super exciting. And finally, Filecoin Discover, which will seed the network with really valuable and culturally important data sets that include many of the logos that you see on the screen today. Next up, I'll highlight some of the incredible developer tooling providers that are enabling applications on top of Filecoin. PowerGate is absolutely one of the most popular developer toolkits that allows any developer to deploy a multi-tiered storage across Filecoin and IPFS. If you're a developer and you want to build on Filecoin, please check out PowerGate. It's just an incredible experience. Truffle recently released Preserve, which simplifies the process of preserving long-lived application data on IPFS and Filecoin. And they're actually working on a Ganache integration, which enables developers to spin up local Filecoin simulators for quick development and testing. Now, continuing our cross-chain use cases, we have, of course, mentioned Ethereum, but there's also many others. P2P.org is working on a multi-blockchain ETL for Polkadot and Filecoin. And Ethereum Classic Labs is actually adding support for Filecoin through an open RPC to Lotus, which is really exciting. Protoschool has, of course, released a whole set of courses to onboard new developers onto Filecoin. And I won't ruin the surprise, but you may hear some great news from one of the most popular development suites in Web3 later this week. And finally, in terms of token infrastructure, there are just a number of wallets that are supporting Filecoin today, including Ledger, which is available now, the Glyph self-hosting wallet, which is also available, MetaMask support, which is coming soon, and Trust Wallet, which should be available shortly. And there are a number of custody providers that are already helping token holders custody their Filecoin, including Coinbase, Gemini, and Anchorage. Okay, so that was just a quick rapid fire overview of the applications and clients in the ecosystem. And there are many, many more that will be featured over the course of the week. I have to say we have some of the most creative and brightest minds in Web3 working on applications. So I can say with absolute certainty that the future of the network is in great hands. So next I'll touch on the community. There are currently over 4,500 folks that have actively contributed to GitHub repos on the Filecoin network today. And that's a staggering amount for a project that just kicked off its mainnet. These thousands of contributors have contributed to over 200 repos, including the core protocol, Filecoin proofs, developer tooling and APIs, and products and applications. I also want to highlight that there are four independent teams working on developing four separate implementations of the Filecoin protocol. Lotus, which is live today, Venus, formerly known as GoFilecoin, which is being developed by the IPFS Force team, Forest, which is an implementation in Rust being developed by Chainsafe, and Fuhan, which is an implementation in C++ developed by Soramitsu. These implementations will ensure additional security and functionality of the network as they launch. So we're so excited to hear from them and their progress this week. We'll also want to highlight some of the other collaborators that are around the Filecoin ecosystem. And that includes ecosystem partners like the Ethereum Foundation, the Web3 Foundation, ETH Global, Gitcoin Consensus, and others. Developers like Supernational, who's made some incredible improvements to the speed and performance of our proof systems, Carbon5, Digital Mob, Keiko, and others, and research collaborators, including the Stanford Center for Blockchain Research, IC3, Block Science, and contributors from various universities. Together, we've come together, put together tons of meetups all over the world to spread the word on Filecoin and encourage more folks to contribute, and run some really professional global conferences all around the world. So in short, I want to thank all the contributors and community members of Filecoin from all around the world. You are truly the ambassadors and the voice of the project, and Filecoin's future is safely in your hands. Finally, I'm going to highlight some of the new projects that are entering the Filecoin ecosystem. And I'm so proud to say that over 250 new teams are entering the ecosystem as we speak. And that's partially through the program of Filecoin Ignite, which we launched about a couple of months ago, where developers can learn, build, and launch on the Filecoin network. I'll highlight just a few of the examples of some of the on-ramps that some of these development teams are using to come onto the Filecoin network. First is the HackFS hackathon, which was run by ETH Global. This was a one-month hackathon that occurred in July, and over 470 hackers participated. Over 134 projects were submitted, over 50 countries and 19 time zones. And there's just a wealth of video data on the YouTube channel for ETH Global if you want to check out any of those projects. Additionally, if you go to this link, you can see the over 130 projects that were submitted and are largely live today, all of which have really incredible use cases on Filecoin. Next, the Spark Hackathon also occurred at the same time. And this was a participation of over 800 participants, 100 teams, 40 universities, six continents, and 30 teams built projects on the Filecoin network. Apollo is another program. This one's powered by Gitcoin, and it's a community of Filecoin builders that are going through a six-week mentorship program. There are 130 Apollo fellows and 50 teams in the program, and they make up an incredibly talented group, founders that have started over 25 tech companies and represent over 40 countries. These group of folks are building their MVPs and their initial use cases on Filecoin, and we're so excited to see their showcase on Wednesday during the build day of this week. Filecoin Launchpad is powered by Tachyon. This is an accelerator program for 13 teams who are building serious companies and organizations on the Filecoin network. They'll receive $80,000 in investment, 3 months of intense membership, and participate in a demo day in January to attract Series A investment. And over 100 applications came in for this one, and we picked, Tachyon picked 13 teams, and we're super excited to have them on board. And finally, just announced last week is the Filecoin Frontier Accelerator. This is based in Singapore and in Shanghai, and it's a program for 10 teams who are building serious companies and organizations on Filecoin. Teams will receive $20,000 in grants and a demo day that is co-sponsored by Fembushi Capital and many others. And you can apply for this program today. It kicks off in February. It's going to be an absolutely incredible program for serious teams that want to build in Asia. And of course, there are many, many more to come. So a huge thank you to the 250 plus teams that are entering the ecosystem as we speak. You guys are learning, building, and launching on the Filecoin ecosystem. And frankly, I really think you'll be the pioneers of future applications and use cases on the network. So that was a quick overview of the four major stakeholder participants. And I moved pretty quickly, but there'll be a lot more to showcase over the course of the week. But I did want to leave with one final message, and that's really a heartfelt thank you to the organizations, the individuals that are so committed to developing the Filecoin ecosystem. This includes miners, ecosystem developers and collaborators, and such a large community of community members and developers that are contributing to the protocol. Thank you for advancing our collective mission. You are all helping make Filecoin a reality, and we're super excited and grateful to be building alongside you. We all know that major change that needs to happen to our cloud storage infrastructure to set Web3 up for the future. So together, let's be the ones to preserve humanity's information. So thank you very, very much. That was my presentation. And I'm going to set this up and introduce Dan Bonnet, who's our next speaker. Dan Bonnet is a professor of computer science at Stanford University, where he heads up applied cryptography and co-directs the computer security lab. Dan's research focuses on applications of cryptography to computer security. His work includes crypto systems with novel properties, web security, cryptography for blockchains, and crypto analysis. He is the author of over 150 publications in the field and a recipient of the 2014 ACM Prize, the 2013 Goodell Prize, the RSA Award in Mathematics, and six Best Paper Awards. In 2016, Bonnet was elected to the National Academy of Engineering. And from a personal perspective, he's been an absolutely incredible mentor to the Filecoin team and for our community for many, many years.